Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside of theuptrend.com with your daily market outlook for Friday, March 28th, 2008. I'm running a little behind this morning, had some technical issues, sorry about that. We see the futures are up in the pre-market this morning. We had some economic reports come out at 8:30, showing that consumer spending was basically flat. And then JCPenney came out and reported, and they've got, nobody's going to be happy with their numbers, so look for JCPenney to pull down the market today. Now, we are still looking at going through this window dressing, end of the quarter window dressing cycle. So we are still looking for some upward pressure on some of the hottest stocks lately. But the market overall, we're looking for it to stall out here and start moving lower. Now, we had the NASDAQ down sharply yesterday. So we're looking at the 60-minute charts here. We ran right back down to that previous area of resistance that we had mentioned before at the 2281 area. On Friday, we're going to be looking for a move up above 2315 on an hourly basis to give us a new intraday buy signal on the NASDAQ on Friday. For the S&P 500, we're going to be looking for a move up above 1342. And for the TSX was sitting on the edge of a short-term sell signal yesterday afternoon. We've got commodities down in the pre-market this morning. So if you want to give, the TSX is probably just going to start on an intraday sell signal this morning. If you want to give it a bit more room, you could wait till an hourly close below 13,300. Again, we're looking at 60-minute charts. Again, we're looking at intraday activity. So if you are watching the markets on Friday, we're looking for an hourly close below 13,300 on the TSX to give us a new intraday sell signal. Now, one of the things I wanted to take a look at this morning was our market breadth. So these charts are the percentage of stocks in these indexes that are above their 10-day moving average. And the basic theme here is that we've just come off the top for a lot of these indexes. Now, you know, when you see them down at the bottom here, that might not be the perfect time to buy, but there's certainly a lot less risk to be buying down when you've got very few stocks trading above their 10-day moving average, and you've got much more risk when you consider buying a stock when this indicator is at the top of a 10-day moving average. Again, we're looking at very short-term. These are very short-term indicators. Obviously, they go up and down all the time, but if you look, this is the S&P 500. Next one we're looking at here is the NASDAQ 100. We've just come off a nice move up to about 90% of the stocks trading above their 10-day moving average. That usually indicates a short-term market top. This is the airline sector, and you can see we had a nice move up, very close to 100% of the stocks trading above their 10-day moving average, and we're coming off of that at the moment. This is the biotech sector, similar situation. We're right up at a very high end of the range, up at 70%. You can see that's the highest we've had since last fall. This one is the energy sector. Energy sector could still go higher, but again, we're up at the top of the range. Looking at financials, of course, financials we're watching very, very closely. We saw them come down again yesterday. Spider Financial Index was down over 1.5%. Canadian financial market did fairly well yesterday, even though I threw that thing up about CIBC. One of the agencies raised expectations on one of the banks, and Canadian bank stocks did fairly well yesterday. But, you know, when you look at this, you can see we are coming off the top of the range, so we are looking for a move down in this sector. Chip sector. Notice the chip sector has been in a downtrend for such a long time, and so any move to the upside has been very, very limited. You know, anytime that you've got a move up here, you know, we've got a very, very little move in the actual index itself. This is a very wounded sector, and so again, you know, even though we've had a nice run up from down here to the top of the range again, you know, that really doesn't move the stocks that much at this particular time. Hopefully that'll change at some time in the future. Technology stocks, similar situation. We've had a nice run to the top of the range, and we're looking to come back down. And the last chart of the morning is the transportation sector. And I've mentioned this before, but I'm really watching, you know, the next time we're going to run down and look at making a major run to the downside, we're going to need to see the transportation sector sell off. Now, we are coming off the top of the range. That doesn't mean that we're going to get an instantaneous sell-off. We could just come back down to the trend line here. But if we start to break down below this March low here on the transportation sector, then I would say that the market is in for a hell of a time. So that's all for this week, folks. We're looking for some window dressing on Friday and Monday, and then we look for continued down move starting in early April. Have a great weekend, folks, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.